She has no husband no more. She has credit beyond what she can stand. She has no money. She has no friends. She has become a mockery in the neighborhood. Everyone's making fun of this woman. This woman does not see past today. She has hung her hat up on today. She says, I have nothing at all but a little bit of oil in a bottle. The prophet says, let me show you this from a different perspective. Allow me to show you how you can take what you have and make it greater than what you thought. You can't only lean on your perspective, and that is why it's good to come to the house of the Lord so that we can hear the testimonies of the saints. Now you may be dealing with the same situation, but you feel different about it because God will show you a different sign of the same thing. So he says, listen, this is what I want you to do. I want you to take that empty pot of oil, and I want you to begin to knock on doors. Don't you know that the foolish things of God is greater than man's wisdom? Amen. For the weakness of God is greater than man's strength. For you see your calling, brethren, how that not many wise are called, and how that not many noble are chosen. But God has chosen the base things of this world to confound the wise. God said, if you're going to walk with me, you'll look foolish sometimes. If you're going to walk with me, people are going to make fun of you sometimes. If you're going to walk with me, you've got to understand that it's going to look ridiculous sometimes. If you're going to walk with me, you've got to understand that, thank you, praise the Lord. If you're going to walk with me, you must understand that when you sow into me, I've got something behind my back that I'm about to bless you with. So the woman moved in obedience. She began to knock on every door. She said, the prophet told me to knock on the door. And the people began to laugh. They said, amen, she's crazy. She's foolish. Just give her a little bottle so she could go on her way. She lost her mind. She lost her husband. The debtors are there. They were lifting up the blinds, looking all the time long, looking at her, laughing at her. She's going to sleep crying because she can't see her way out. But let me tell you, we'll see who's foolish when God begins to bless her. We'll see who's foolish when God begins to fill the bottles of oil. We'll see who's foolish when I've been worshiping God and it looked like God was not going to bring me through. We'll see who's foolish when you talked about me, but my God came to redeem me. We'll see who's foolish when I give my tithe out of my last and God provides. We'll see who's foolish. So the old woman comes with the bottle of oil, and she comes to knock on the door. She knocks on the door. She says, do you have any more, any empty bottles? They said, oh man, here, give this crazy woman some bottles. She says, thank you. She grabs the bottles. She goes and she takes the little bit of oil that she has and pours it into the empty bottle, and God fills the whole bottle up. God, wait a minute now. He says, go back to another neighbor. She goes to another neighbor and she knocks on the door. And she says, do you have any empty bottles? She said, oh, she lost her husband. You know about her. She's crazy. Give her another bottle. Let's just appease her. They gave her another bottle. She went behind closed doors. Amen. When you enter into prayer and you go behind closed doors, what you do in secret, God will reward you openly. The woman goes behind closed doors. She puts the empty bottle down and she takes the bottle that has a little bit of oil and pours it into an empty bottle, and the Lord supernaturally causes the oil to come to the top. She says, oh, you ain't gotta tell me what to do. Now I know. She goes and she knocks on the door. Do you have any more bottles? They say, oh, get this crazy woman some more bottles. The woman comes and she comes behind closed doors and she knows now because she has experience with God. She grabs the oil and pours it into the empty bottle, and the Lord again fills up the bottle. She said, prophet, you ain't got to tell me nothing. I know what you do. She walks and she goes and she knocks on the door. She gets another bottle, an empty bottle. She comes. She comes behind closed doors and fills the bottle up. She did that back and forth over and over again until she filled the table with bottles of oil. Now I told you that oil was valuable during that time. That woman took those bottles of oil and sold them to the marketplace. And she was able to have enough to take care of her and her sons. What am I saying? As you look at your situation, it may appear as if you don't have enough. And it may appear as if you don't have everything. But let me tell you, I want you to take the little bit of peace that you have and sow it in the spirit. I want you to take the little bit of love that you have and sow it in the spirit. I want you to take the few dollars that you have and sow it in the spirit. I want you to take the little bit of worship that you have and sow it in the spirit. Stop telling God, I don't have nothing. God looks at what you have as a tool to give you more. God said, I need you to give me some of your stuff. This is a relationship. We got to build this relationship. If you'll share with me, I'll share with you. And listen, I have 1,000 cattle upon a hill. If there was need of anything, I would not ask of thee. I'm just building a relationship with you. So my question to you today is, do you have the spirit of a desperate housewife? Because once you're desperate, nothing's going to stop you from reaching your destiny. God will tell you things to do that don't make sense. God will tell you to stay in situations that look foolish. God will tell you to give when you don't have anything to give. God will tell you to start a church when you're the only one coming. God will tell you to start a business when the market is dropping. God will tell you to take a vacation when you can't seem to pay any bills. But I'm telling you, once you sow into God, God is faithful to watch over his word. And even though you may struggle for a while, I promise you, if you continue to do what is right, God will show you in time. And the same ones that did not believe that God was going to do what God promised you will see you move in the things that God told you you would do. I wonder if desperate housewife number one got in touch with desperate housewife number two and shared, desperate housewife number one, I only had a little bit of flour and a little oil. My son was wondering how God was going to bring us through. And I never doubted him. I said, God will make a way. And he said, Mama, I don't see it. And he said, I trust God. And he said, yeah, that's fine, but I don't see it. And you continued to cry and worship God. And God brought an answer your way. And then you got in touch with desperate housewife number two, who was over here and said, all I have is a jar with a little bit of oil. I don't see how I'm going to make it out of this. This situation seems unbearable. But what about if desperate housewife number one tells her testimony to desperate housewife number two? And they meet in the middle, and the glory of God begins to go back and forth when we talk about the goodness of God and how God brought us out and how God saw us through and how God made a way. So desperate housewife number one said, listen, I have my last meal. I'm going to eat it with my son, and we're going to die. But since it's my last meal, and I know I'm going to die anyhow, I really don't have anything to lose. What if this is God? Because if I eat it, I already said I'm going to die. And if I give it and he take it, I'm going to still die. But what if the truth of me sowing right now will bring me abundant life?
Yes,
Lord.
Yes.
Desperate housewife number two says, I only have a little bit of oil. In fact, I have nothing. And the devil has told us, you're nothing.
Yes.
You'll never amount to anything.
Yes.
Look at so-and-so. The thing I love about God, and I want you all to hear this, God will never, ever compare us to each other.
Yes.
We do
yes.
that.
Yes.
God does not do that.
Yes.
And we oftentimes forfeit yes. our blessings because we look at yes. someone else. Yes. We'll say, God's not blessing me
yes.
because look at so-and-so.
Yes.
God's
Soul Redeeming Ministries. Restore men and women back to the Lord through the Word, love, and Spirit of God. Come worship with us Sundays at 10 a.m. at the Rochester Auditorium Theater, 3rd floor, Suite 300.